Hello everyone, today we will be discussing the famous poem Goblin Market. It is a narrative poem written by Christina Rossetti and it is published in 1862. The story revolves around two sisters, Lizzie and Laura. Every evening when the sisters go to fetch water from a nearby stream, they hear the tempting calls of goblin men selling delicious fruit. The goblins share physical characteristics with animals, including dogs, rats, wombats, and cats, and they have kind, pleasant voices. Lizzie warns her sister that they shouldn't look at the goblins or buy their fruits, as she is suspicious of their effects. The incurably curious Laura looks directly at the goblins. Lizzie puts her fingers in her ears and runs away, leaving Laura on her own. The goblins approach Laura and seem delighted to find her alone. Laura wants to buy their fruit but has no money to offer in exchange. The goblins accepts a lock of Laura's hair as payment for the fruit. Laura drinks her fill of fruit juice and returns home with a fruit pit. The enchantment of the fruit is one of addiction. Having tasted it, the victim desires nothing but another taste, which the goblins refuse. Lizzie scolds Laura for staying out so late and reminds her of the fate of Jenny. Jenny is a young woman like Laura, accepted the fruit from the goblins. After eating the fruit, Jenny was abandoned by the goblins. She pined away and dies. Now no flower will grow on her grave. Days pass and Laura pines for the fruit. She listens in the hopes of once more hearing the goblins, but she never again hears their cry. Laura remembers a seed that she took from one of the goblin fruit and she plants it, hoping it will grow one day. After some futile attempts to plant the fruit pit, Laura despairs. She stops eating and working. Her hair begins to turn grey and she ages prematurely. Lizzie, greatly concerned for her sister, takes a silver penny to purchase some fruits from the goblins. The goblin man invites Lizzie to join their feast, but she refuses. The goblins turn violent and tries to feed her the fruit by force. Lizzie escapes and returns home all covered in the goblin fruit juice. She calls out to Laura and tells her to drink the juice from her face. Soon Laura is healed of her sickness. The final stanza of the poem is an epilogue in which the two sisters tell their children the story of Goblin Market with the moral, "For there is no friend like a sister in calm or stormy weather." That's the end of the summary. If you like this video, please do like, share and subscribe.